Hey lovelies, I'm back with another video, and yes, it's a sewing video. Y'all gonna have to get used to these sewing videos, cause like, I've been showcasing that this channel is hair, fashion, and beauty, but it should be like hair, sewing, and beauty, because, well, just hair and sewing, cause I don't really post too many beauty stuff. But anyways, I'm rambling. Let's get into it. I'm making a vest. My son wanted a Beyblade birthday party, and he wanted to dress up like Vault, so I'm just basically making the pattern for the vest that character is wearing. And once I finish that, we're gonna get into the shirt that he was wearing as well. So we're just focusing on the vest right now. I made the seam allowance for the zipper, and I'm gonna go ahead and trace this half of the vest. So this is the front piece that I'm tracing. I'm getting the armhole, I'm doing the shoulders, I'm doing the neck. And this pattern, I'm basically doing the whole neck, which is the, like, I'm basically doing the neck band and the shoulder connected. You usually have a neck band piece and then the rest of the actual bodice pattern for the vest, but I just did everything as one. Is that a great idea? Not necessarily, but it still worked out well, and he said it was definitely comfortable. But he's a little kid, like a lot of things is comfortable to them. So I definitely made another vest for my godson for his birthday, and I'll definitely post that soon as well, which it has a neck piece. Basically, the things that I missed in this video will be seen in that video. So I'm working on the pocket pattern right now. I basically made this pattern off a video that I seen. It was two videos that I seen, and one has the actual pattern, but you have to buy it. And the other one, she made her own pattern based off that other video. I'll have them both linked in the description bar below. So I decided to just make my own pattern as well, because I was doing this the day before his party. And I also want to mention, any part that is like scribbled out, that's because I made a mistake and I was working in permanent Sharpie marker, so you guys can actually see. So that's why I usually do stuff in pencil first. So yeah, I didn't do that this time, but the part that scribbled out is what I'm not using. But anyways, I in total came out with three patterns. So that will be the front and back bodice piece, which the back you will put on fold on your fabric, and the front you could just cut out regular, but you're folding each pattern in half because this is a two-tone vest. If you're making a one-tone vest, like one color, then you of course don't have to fold the pattern in half like you see me doing. But in total, I will have six pieces of fabric of my main fabric. My main fabric will have six pieces, four for the front of the vest and two for the back of the vest. And for my lining fabric, I'll just have three pieces, so two front pieces and one back piece. Anyways, like you see on the side, I will be putting front sides facing, and I will pin them together, and it will end up being one whole piece for that vest front and back. So basically the wrong side should be up looking at you and the right side should be facing each other. So it end up looking like this because you're gonna sew a straight stitch going straight across, connecting both fabric pieces together, and it will look like this. And once you finish doing that, I'm going to top stitch the seam allowance down. So once you top stitch the seam allowance down, you're gonna top stitch it really close to the seam line, and it's gonna look like this. As you can see, there is really close to the seam line, and that way your seam allowance will just be laying in one direction and it won't be bulky. Now we're gonna get into cutting the batting. I wanted his vest to have a little puff to it, so I cut out some batting, and I'm gonna go ahead and start by putting the lines and stuff like that that I need to sew onto this so that it looks like a puffer vest. It'll give that puffer look, and that's basically what I was going for. I'm going to show a picture of the character so you can see what I was going for. And I didn't really have an exact measurement of how big I wanted the spaces to be in between, so I just used the ruler as the space that I want in between each stitch. So that's how I got my line spacing, and I did the same for the two front pieces and the back piece. Then I'm gonna sew across each of those lines. I'm gonna do the same for the front two pieces and the one back piece, and that's basically what it should have looked like when you're done. Now moving on to the pocket piece, I cut out a few fleece pieces, so in total I have four of those pieces, and I'm gonna sew that onto the main pocket piece because I want the pocket to feel nice and warm, and that's gonna allow it to feel nice and warm. So I'm gonna sew around that piece with a straight stitch, and then I'm gonna move on to the pattern. Now as you see, the pattern is different. It's on a see-through paper, so I use tracing paper and I trace the pattern out so it could be better and clearer, and I'm gonna go ahead and mark exactly what I want on my piece that's on the pattern onto my actual fabric. So I'm marking it on the wrong side of the fabric, and I'm slitting into the pattern just so I can make sure that I get this box exactly how I need it to be. So I'm gonna go ahead and use my ruler. I'm gonna lift up the pattern as you see a little bit, and I'm gonna mark where the box starts and where it ends. I'm gonna do the same for the other end of it, and then that way I know when I move the pattern I could go ahead and just make my straight lines going up and down because I already marked where that box started and ended on both sides going vertically. I'm going to flip the pattern over. So as you saw, on one pocket I had it right side up, and on the other pocket I flipped the pattern onto the wrong side and transferred those markings onto that sleeve. So they basically have to mirror each other. So you're gonna have a box right there. So I basically put pins in where I made that straight line going straight down that pocket piece, and I'm gonna fold the pocket piece over, and I'm gonna sew a straight line going down that pocket piece where it meets the rectangle box that I transferred from my pattern onto my fabric. Once I do that, I'm gonna pin my pocket to my front bodice piece, and I'm gonna sew a rectangle as close as I can to the seam line, the stitch line that I have already made that straight line going across that we did already, and I'm going to then split that in the middle, and I'm gonna get as close as I can to the stitches that has already been sewn, but I'm not gonna cut through it because if I do, this will not work, it will rip. Okay, so we're gonna push the pocket pieces inside to the back of that front bodice piece. And once you get to the back of the front bodice piece, you're gonna lay everything nice and flat and make sure everything is basically looking right, feeling right, and is not tucked into the front. We need all of that to the back of the piece. And as you see, you're gonna have two triangle pieces. It's going to be the batting and the piece that we had slit and cut. We're gonna cut the batting. We're gonna cut the batting because we don't need that excessive bulk. Once we get the batting done and out of the way, we're gonna go ahead and sew that triangle piece and the flap of the pocket, the part that you'll be seeing on the outside of the pocket, the welt part, I believe. We're gonna sew those two pieces together. We're gonna get as close to the stitch line as you see where I'm pointing. We're just sewing where the triangle piece starts and where it ends. Once you finish doing that, you're gonna go ahead and fold up your pocket and sew all the way around it. Let's stop for a notification shout out to Natural Nikki. Thank you for always being in the comments showing love. I'm gonna do more of these because I want y'all to know that I see y'all showing love and supporting your girls, so thank you so much. And it should look something like this. And once you finish and do that on both sides, we're gonna go ahead and connect the two front pieces to the back piece and make sure it's right sides facing. We're gonna sew a straight stitch down the sides and the shoulder and the neck, and it should look like this. Now we're on to the lining. I used fleece for the lining, and the same thing I did to the outer fabric, I'm gonna do for the lining. I'm gonna sew the neck and the shoulders, as you see, and down the sides. Once that is completed, we're going to put the zipper in. I use a separating zipper, and I sewed that off camera. I will link a video to show how you can do this, and then I'm going to pin the right sides facing of my lining fabric and my outer fabric together, sandwiching that zipper in the middle. And I'm going to also pin the neckline going straight across, making sure all of the seams match up from the outer fabric and the lining fabric, and we're all using a straight stitch. Once that is completed, you're gonna turn it inside out just to make sure everything is looking good and nice and neat. And then we're gonna flip the fabric like down the middle where the neck piece is, because we're going to stitch that seam allowance down. So everything is looking good, the vest is coming along great, and that's how we want things to look. You could cut out the extra bulk and stuff like that from the seam allowance so that everything can just line up better. And this is what I was talking about. I basically sewed the seam allowance down to the lining fabric because I want the lining fabric to stay to the back of the vest. Now I'm gonna flip the lining fabric over. So basically we're gonna have the right sides facing each other again because we're gonna sew up the bottom. We're almost done with this vest. So we're gonna sew up the bottom. We're gonna make sure our seams match up and we're gonna pin everything in place, but we're going to miss a little section. And I'm gonna show you, we're gonna miss that section here just enough so you will be able to turn the vest inside out once we finish stitching it up, and it should look like this. So we're gonna go ahead and flip this vest to the right side, and once we flip it to the right side, we're going to top stitch the opening together and you're done. I use ripstop nylon fabric for the outer layer of this vest and fleece fabric for the lining of the vest. And I wouldn't recommend the nylon fabric because I don't like it. I don't recommend it. Yeah, but it did what it needed to do for what I needed it to do. Now, I was looking all over for party favors, party decorations for this Beyblade birthday party. So I really had to dig into my creativity basket in the head and come up with all of these little things to make sure that his party is looking nice and enjoyable and special to him. So as you see, this is the shirt that I made to go with his vest, and we're about to get into that right now. Now I took a turtleneck shirt, I think I got it from Cookies, and I went ahead and took some white cotton interlock stretch fabric, and I just made it as well. I have no measurements for what I did. I literally just eyeballed it and cut. That's basically it. Like, I didn't use pattern for this or anything because this is a DIY transformation at this point. If you're trying to do this as well, you just measure out how much you think that white fabric you would need. I believe mine's is 3 inches. The length is however long the shirt is, and make sure you add seam allowance so you can fold it over to hem it at the bottom. And I basically pinned it to the shirt. So I pinned it probably 2 inches away from where I split the shirt in half. And I'm going to take my tape measure and do the same for the other side. Put it 2 inches away from the slit edge and mark where I need to sew going straight down. I'm gonna pin the pieces onto my shirt and go ahead and sew that into place using a straight stitch. And it should look like this. Now that is how we want it, we're gonna go ahead and cut the excess fabric that we don't need anymore off, and we're gonna do the same what we do on one side, we're gonna do on the other. And once that's complete and looking how we want it, we're gonna work on the neck piece. As you saw, I had already cut the neckband off of the shirt, and I cut a white piece. I think it was 5 inches in width, and probably like however long the neckband is in length to begin with once it's not folded in half. And I'm gonna go ahead and cut the white strip that I had cut out in half, so it should be 2 pieces, which is 2.5 in width, and I'm gonna go ahead and sew it to the turtleneck part. and on each side so that it fit nicely on a regular shirt. I probably cut like 2 inches off of the regular neck band so that the white pieces take up that space that I cut off the original neck band. Then I'm gonna go ahead and attach it to the shirt neckline. So basically I'm gonna fold the neck band in half again and I'm gonna go ahead and attach it back to the shirt. So I gotta stretch the neck band to make sure that it fits all the way around the neckline of the shirt. And I'm matching the white with the white so that the blue matches up and the white matches up. Once that's complete, we're gonna hem the bottom of the shirt. So remember I said leave seam allowance, so that's what we're gonna do. We're gonna fold the seam allowance over and we're gonna do 2 top stitches to match the original stitch line of the shirt, the original hem line of the shirt. We're gonna go ahead and focus on the zipper. Basically, I hope you can see what I'm doing. So I'm basically like folding like 1/4 inch to the back, and then like if I would hem it, but instead of hemming it straight away, we're just gonna place that right on top of the zipper. I have so many tutorials of me doing this, so I hope y'all know what I'm talking about. Well, not tutorials, but videos of me doing this, but hopefully you can see clearly what I'm doing anyways. So you see I'm folding it in, and once I fold it in, I'm going to pin it to the zipper. I like separate the zipper a little bit so I can pin it, but I want to make sure that I'm pinning it evenly so they're even on both sides. Once you sew that down, we're gonna go ahead and work on the neck band. So the neck band is unfinished and I'm folding in the raw edges to the inside. I'm gonna tuck that zipper piece that's left out, usually that's on the top, I'm gonna tuck that inside, basically sandwiching it in between the fabric, and I'm gonna sew a straight stitch to finish up the neck band. And then I'm gonna sew the 2 pieces together of the front to make it one whole piece, and I'm gonna sew a straight stitch and it will look like this. So your shirt is basically almost done. Now if you wasn't doing short sleeves, your shirt would be done. I'm doing short sleeves because the character have short sleeves, so I'm gonna cut the sleeve and I'm going to hem it. Now I'm extra, I like to put like little designs and stuff on it so he knows it's his birthday shirt, and that's what I did. And the character has like a stripe going down his sleeve, and I just used some vinyl for that because I didn't feel like using more fabric. And this is the finished look. My boy is his character bolt, you feel me? I think I did a good job.
That's it.
That was a blooper of him posing. I wrote Beyblade. A video on his hair is coming next, so look out for that. And if you have any questions, leave them down below. Until next time, lovelies, later.